Welcome everybody here to your broadcast of the CDEC. I'm Toby One. I'll be your host for the English Lion Stream today. We've been having capitalists doing the last couple of days across Group 1. Of course, there are 3 days of play for each of the groups, and only 2 teams can advance themselves forward, where they get to join the 4 directly invited teams. Of course, the team which we have playing first is a team which people will say, hey, shouldn't they have actually been directly invited? And well, so far they've proved throughout the group stage that yes, they probably should have. But there's just so much great quality teams coming out of China right now, the newbie found themselves down here in Group A. Of course, they've had a flawless run going 2-0, but the team they're going up against, Dreamtime, have also had a flawless run so far, also going 2-0. So this battle will be for first position. We'll have our battle for third position coming up directly after this. So 2 best of 1s coming your way tonight. Let's get ourselves into the game, everybody, because you know it's that time. It's that time to play some good Dota.
No.
That's at least what I'm hoping for. If we don't get good Dota, I may just go and be very, very sad about life, everything in the universe. But yeah, let's look at that draft. So I was actually wondering who would be picking up the Enchantress in this game. Looking through the previous couple of games of both newbie as well as Tongfu, Enchantress actually getting flagged a lot higher. One of the other ones that was flagged very, very high was actually for newbie. They're running a lot. I'm realizing our audio level's a little bit high for that one. Shadow Shaman is actually one of their favorite heroes at the moment, but newbie already opening up. Now, there's not really that much at stake for this game. For both of our games today, we may be seeing teams being a little bit more inventive because basically you're already through.
Fu's turn to pick.
Both these teams are already directly through into the next part of the game, into the next part of the series. Number one position, we're actually still trying to work out. I was asking Marley early today, going, who's the guy who also hooked us up? Shout out to Marley. And asking around, going, hey, so if you're number one, who do you actually go up against? Because the other teams which are there in the group, in the grid, probably don't want to get newbie. It'll be the hardest game you could possibly get at the very, very start. There's DK, VG Gaming, IG, and LGDCN. All 4 teams, very, very formidable. Newbie, they're the team that went to Mars TV and destroyed them all. So, hey, I'm interested to see exactly how that's all going to unfold, because the main competition is going to begin next week, I believe it is. So, it's 2 weeks from now. So we got some time to wait. It'll happen after DreamHack. So Wraith King, Brewmaster, and Enchantress, the pickups here from Tongfu. So with Wraith King, Enchantress, and Brewmaster, we've already got a lot of stayability during the fights. That would be the first thing I'd add to it. I like the Lion pickup. It's the best way of getting around like heroes like Enchantress who have this continuous heal. And also great for trying to bring down that Brewmaster, because you got both Wraith King. Wraith King dies, reincarnates back up again. All of a sudden, hey, what am I supposed to really be doing here? Not a hell of a lot, because I've already used everything I've got on the Wraith King, and he's reincarnated, so he's back to full strength again. But then you get the Brewmaster as well. You got to kill him off before he's able to do the split. So you got 2 heroes, one that basically soaks it up, and the other one who kind of wants to soak it up, but still get his split off. But the Finger of Death makes it very difficult for Brewmaster to time that split perfectly. Not to mention, Lion's got some of the best disables in the game. Not only like his Finger of Death for the burst damage, but both the stun as well as the Hex, that primarily will be there to catch out the Brewmaster. It's also another support hero which newbie were playing a lot of during this competition. If I actually just check back right now as I do my own little stat work right now. They ended up having like newbies lineup for the 2 supports. The first game they actually ran a Shadow Shaman as well as a Dream Protector, and then they actually ran the Enchantress as well as Shadow Shaman. Maybe it was Dreamtime that had the line in their mix up, but either way, still a great pickup, still works, still does the job. Bristleback and Doombringer, he's another one of these guys that'll be able to control up the Brewmaster. So the chance of Brewmaster being able to create some nice chaos during the games is pretty, pretty low. And I was right. I kept my double-checking going, and it was Kabu who played it up against Dreamtime. So it was Tongfu versus Dreamtime. And that was when they ran Lion, Brewmaster, Darkseer, Void, as well as the Enchantress. We're going to get a Mirana pickup here from Tongfu. So we're starting to, like they're still open as far as who their cores are. More than likely, if we go with the trends in China of recent times, that will actually be a support Mirana. As if we go with the trends, of course. Also, previously in this series, group stage, we did actually see a core Mirana being played up. So Wraith King can still go either way here with the Mirana. So they're not really shut into one set of options. Where newbie, they kind of are. Like, you got Bristleback, Doombringer, and Puck. Now, this should be a safe lane farming Doombringer. We should have Mu on the puck, and we should have the offlane Xiaowei Bristleback, which then just pushes the Lion plus one extra supporter into the trees. Like, that's into the trees, into the last position. Why the... Oh, my Lord. It's going to be a good day today, peoples. It's going to be a good day today. What I actually kind of like about this lineup is the fact, like, you've at least got one mana drainer in your lineup. Now, that's one way you can get around the Wraith King. Like, obviously, Doom doesn't actually stop Wraith King as long as he's got enough mana. He's actually quite good. But if you can hold the Wraith King in position long enough, it might be worthy, like, getting a couple of extra points up in that mana drain. Just two should be enough from Lion. And then just drain the Wraith King out. Because if you're capable of doing that, then you take away its ultimate, you take away a lot of its fighting potential. Not to mention, like, it's a really low cooldown for mana drain anyway, so... 5 seconds remaining. Maybe they can just zone out that Wraith King with a hero like a Lion, reserve but time. You'll need a secondary controller right now. Because Puck's Dream Coil, Doom, and... Well, I don't really want to count Snot. Or Nasal Goo, as it's called. Snot. From the Bristleback. It's a nice little bit of a slow, but that's really all you're going to get from it. And the Wind Ranger comes in from Tongfu. Radiant team pick. So we get our offlaner, another hero who was actually really good against this lineup of newbie. At the same time, like, did Rubick actually get taken out? No, he didn't. Whenever I see heroes like both like Mirana and Wind Ranger who have to use like movement speed or like jumps, you can still actually telekinesis when Mirana in midair. But if you're able to get like those heroes picked up and thrown back during their escape times, they really cannot run themselves away. And they can't outrun a Doombringer. Like, that Doombringer, he gets the Scorched Earth off during a team fight or even just during a chase, and he will chase you underneath the towers. Having both regeneration and really high movement speed allows you to make sure that nobody escapes your clutches. I would love to know how someone actually found my stream from Period Flax's stream, but I love it anyway. I love it. I'm glad people are sharing the love, people. Hope you enjoyed the live broadcasts. I know there's a couple of rebroadcasts going on, which are stealing all the viewers, but hey, we're here for fun, peoples. All right, so newbie, give us your last hero. Should be a support hero as well. My money is still going to be on not that one. Okay, so greed. Greed is eternal. Greed is eternal. And all they really wanted was friends. But newbie, going to pick up the Viper as the final one here. So this pushes the Doombringer into the jungle now. So we get ourselves the greedy lineup where you're able to just run your Doombringer inside the jungle. I'm just going to double check and make sure our live stream is also going okay. Because we did actually... I haven't actually told anyone this yet, but I don't know if you guys have noticed. I'm going to just refresh our camera input. It looks okay. It looks okay. Woo! Okay, so it's just XSplit doing its normal frame rate drop on the screen. That's cool. Alright, so yeah, into the game we go. So, as far as the game goes, as far as the studio goes, we're actually upstairs now. We're up in the new joint editor office. We still have to make a couple of changes, but we'll be all good. Meanwhile, back in the team fight, which could potentially start. The Enchantress doesn't really want to be part of this one. She doesn't have a creep. All she's got is basically a slow and hasn't leveled up the heal. So surviving during the engagements is going to be next to, well, I'm not going to say impossible, but hey, it's not going to be that great. Yeah, so Xiaowei, he's actually going to take the puck towards the offlane, so I get to eat my words on that one. And it's mainly the last pickup, which is kind of throwing that into a little bit of chaos. So Mu will actually take the Viper in towards the middle lane, and that puts Bristleback as the primary farmer down the bottom lane, and puts the Doombringer into the jungle. So he's going to be looking for a nice creep to start with, what he would give for a DD rune, and what he gets is not a DD rune there, it's the DD rune up on the top lane. So Xiaowei can enjoy that one. He's going up against Fox. He's already able to get one nice little hit in there. So welcome to one tango charge down. But he brought 8 with him. So I'm pretty sure Sorry Fox is going to be okay. But look where Xiaowei's moving himself. He knows he's got this DD rune and he knows Windranger can just wait it out. So if he could just come over and delay Fox's movement up. I think he was expecting Fox though to move down this direction. Which is why he moved up where he did. But you can't stay there for too long. You got to get back into the lane and make sure you get all those last hits in, which he just missed one there with a DD rune. But, okay. Is he going to jaunt? Yep, he's going to jaunt. Still got the DD rune. Wind Run has to be used. But he already brought Fox down a half life, and this is just shallow weight. Like, it's fine for him to lose out in this experience because he's still going to grab, like, okay, he's actually still grabbing most of the experience from the lane, just not the last hits of it. But the amount of consumables he'll force the Wind Ranger to go through, that kind of jaunt is fine. While in middle lane, move versus the Brewmaster. So this is just a full-on battle between the two guys as far as, like, if Brewmaster can get in close and clap, then we go into the whole brawl kind of situation. And you could find yourself with a quick kill. And Enchantress is already adding a little bit of pressure towards that too. So he's just hovering around that middle lane. This is when the Doombringer in the jungle actually... it's okay because he's got himself this, like, he's got himself the Wild Wing, so he's got the toughness aura available to himself. So getting an easy kill on him is difficult, but he actually becomes this bit of a filter for the middle lane. Now, Sunshine's going to be very, very careful. About to be stunned up. The Hellbear won't be able to get himself in range, but then Sunshine makes the best decision he could, but at the same time, it's still going to be his death. The arrow was coming in from the Morana. If he kept walking through the tree lines, he would have been hit by that. So he had no other option. The Hellbear's about to... Oh, wait. Whoa, whoa, whoa. And the clap as well. Doesn't matter if Banana picks that up.
Sorry, Doom.
I think his initial thought was just to come in, grab the clapper, and then just do something. Either way, Hal had no intention of coming over there and helping out his teammates because he couldn't. Like, he's still being controlled up here by the Morana on the lane. So he has to remain there. But Kabu... Already off for the Clarity, he doesn't have enough mana for a Hellfire Blast, so that aggressive movement into the lane is really just, well, I say for show, but he can't be seen by Newbie. So it's not really for that much show. But Enchantress is controlling up the jungle. Oh, what an Alpha Wolf. What the thing, what you would give Banana to actually have your Devour off cooldown and not have that Alpha Wolf basically dead already. But he'll try and battle up against the Enchantress, but Enchantress is fine. She's still got 1 point up in the heal, so he's not going to be able to get the kill right now. It's like Brewmaster also, not feeling so healthy. Oh, Banana, you are really chasing this in a long way. And then the haste rune from Brewmaster might try and punish this one. Enchant, it's off cooldown. He's got to go in for the clamp though, with a Hellfire Blast as well. They don't even need the enchant, but they're going, well, like, okay, yeah. They get the kill. 3-0 in favor of Tongfu. Game looking to be a nice quick game by the looks of it, and Tongfu is doing it. I'll just keep the pressure up while Xiao Wei, he's 12 for 5 up against a 5 for 2. So this is the one lane for Newbie, which is working well. I say that, and I should say, like, the Brewmaster and the Viper. Like, Viper wins most lanes. I suppose Brewmaster is kind of like the new Fandangled. I can win anything because I'm just Brewmaster in the early stages. So, yeah, it's a fairly even lane in the middle lane, even though Mudos have a slight advantage here. It's just the fact you've already got 3 kills on the board. And it's across one, your mid solo, which is the Brewmaster. So he's already got his extra cash coming in. And then you got Wraith King as well as the Enchantress. So the supports for Tongfu are going to be looking really nice. Not to mention the Morana on this bottom lane. Actually, I'm surprised her CS isn't really that great. That could also be the presence of Hal. Getting a couple of quills into you, and you're already going to be a little bit more cautious about how close you are in the lane. But Enchantress is on her way over, and hello, Doombringer. He just lost his clarity. He's got regeneration aura, and that's basically it. A Hellfire Blast into an arrow would do the job right now. Now, they use Enchantress to slow him down. Now, there's your Hellfire Blast. The arrow will come down, but Banana can evade this one. He had a tree line to work with, too, while Hal, he's just keeping those quills coming out. And the Morana, she's got 4 quills inside of her. A fifth one may even get the kill right now. In fact, it will. Nah, the Doombringer's blade will do the job. 3-1, and Newbie finally get themselves on the board. Yeah, it's the Doombringer who's able to get that money back into himself and get a little bit more room to breathe on the bottom lane. Newbie so needed that. Without that, they couldn't push Tongfu back out of their own jungle and give that Doombringer space to do what he wants to. Like, this is a greedy lineup from Newbie. Even though, like, the early game might look really bad for them, knowing what they get later into the game, they know it's worth it. A 3-for-1 is perfect for them. Because the Doombringer is going to make his cash back anyway. The only downside is, Banana currently has Devour on cooldown. He's got no mana to use it whatsoever. So all he's doing right now is just basic farming. And his regeneration is 0.6. Now 0.8. Woo! Level 3. His mana regeneration is shite. So he needs to be able to find a little... Like, he needs to actually have that clarity, which he lost. Now, middle lane... Enchant, clap, and the primal split being used. Viper Strike to the Enchantress, but Enchantress just pops off the heel. This is Moo just doing whatever he possibly can to try and stay alive. Way, Enchantress! The soil. Really dropping low there. Wasn't expecting that, because how many points up in Nethertox he got? Just the one. But Enchantress only just barely surviving that one. At least Doomring is able to soak up some experience here in middle lane now. But the Brewmaster Primal Split already got what he wanted. And it's now the second kill coming in for the Brewmaster, which can either mean early Arcane Boots, or if he wants to, considering... Okay, it's giving a bottle charge over. Because it's like, you're not going to pass up the regeneration on a Brewmaster solo mid. But the fact you're able to... the fact you're able to rush a Blink Dagger if you wanted to over on U9, that's going to be the bigger thing for him. Because then you've got the jump and initiation already. Which is kind of something which Tongfu is missing. Like, Wraith King right now is the first setup. It's the Hellfire Blast and the Marana Arrow. That is their setup. And then the Enchantress follows up with whatever support she's got. Speaking of which, we are now moving out the Alpha Wolf to give him the extra damage. And the Centaur. Like, the Centaur's the primary creep here. The extra damage is going to be great, but not great. Oh, Dire Observer Ward is watching Banana come up. Now, because he's standing up on high ground now, he's actually stopped and the smoke broke, but he's too far out. Wolf Stomp, Enchant, Hellfire Blast. He devours actually over on the Centaur. He probably should have been trying to take out that Alpha Wolf because the Centaur had already cast his Wolf Stomp. But either way, like, I thought he'd be just looking for the aura for later on. Dire's middle tower is under attack. But that's now 5-1. These Tongfu rotations have been paying off so much every single time. Love how some guy also said the Doom ulti is overrated. The Doom ulti at level 1, I agree, can be, well, very overrated. But then again, you've got to overrate it to make that happen. So, Hex. Follow-up stun. Doesn't need a mana drain. Just needs to buy the time for the Bristleback to get himself that fourth Quill Spray out. And that's now going to be another kill. Coming the way of Newbie. They get their second one on the board. They're still looking for a rotation to come in here on the Viper. A Saturn this time around. With the Creep Wave that's already there, they can dive under the tower. The Drunken Haze, the Hellfire Blast has to get in range. Now Enchant just coming in through the other side, which means with Enchant and the Clap, Brewmaster is going to split. You realize the TV support's on the way in right now. The Moonlight Shadow's going to try and add a little bit of protection here for the Raid King to try and survive this one, but the Puck Dream Call already did its work. Sunshade's gone inside the tree line, and they're searching for some kind of opening, and well, they all find the Puck. Sends Xiao Wade up into the air, at least a Banana. Again, very, very far up here on the front lines, but it's Hal who's trying to already start the stack up into the Quill Spray. And the best one he can go for right now is Al. And, yeah, just beats him down. With the Haste Rune as well, he can keep up the chase. Well, he can't hope for another rune, so he's just going to go back. Go back and try and keep farming up. So 6-4, Tongfu really trying to overforce the issue underneath that Tier 1 tower in the mid lane. Like, it's still them killing off, like Wraith King was killed off, Newbie, they lost their Marana, they lost their Viper. But really, Newbie came out on top of that one. Because it's, again, another kill coming in for Hal. And this is something which I've got a feeling which Tongfu, they just can't repel the Bristleback coming into the mid-game. Like, actually ignore the Doombringer for now. The Bristleback, once he finishes up his Vanguard, which he can buy right now, it's going to be very difficult to kill off. And those Brulings, like, I've seen it before. Even with this current change. Oh, Xiao Wade. I know you got yourself, like, you used the phase shift to a Vapor that just allows Brewmaster to walk up the hill. And he is rushing a Blink Dagger. But yeah, those Brulings don't survive up against the Bristleback. Like, Bristleback right now for me is one of the best counters to the Brewmaster ultimate. He still obviously needs a little bit of time to tank it up and get those Cool Sprays up a little bit higher in levels. But you basically lose the Brewmaster ultimate almost instantly. And this carries on into the late game too, because you can't protect these units. Like, the more you protect them, the more time you've had Bristleback to get some farm. Now, Illusion Rune stolen. Just jumps up towards the high ground. It's okay. It's just Xiao Wei trying to get some level of rune control. Man, how long has it been since I've seen Robo? Like, it's been a very long time since I've seen someone using this guy. It's a classic. He used to be state-of-the-art technology. And now he's taking the Vanguard down south. Sunshank's still very, very, like... He's still managed to hit 10 for 3, which is better than I can say for a Wraith King, but... Wraith King can't hit that point where he gets level 6. So Kabu should really just remain here on the top lane, unless he can do some pulling. But looks like he's already done that, and that's the reason why they got themselves a double creep wave on top. So maybe this is now a forcing out of the top lane. But Zhao Wei could easily stop this. He's got 4 points up in the orb. Goodbye, Moot. So Viper will go down. He got one ulti off, but again, this Brewmaster ulti. Very rarely have I seen this thing off cooldown. Now he just has to assault the mid-tier one tower. Oh, looks like Puck's actually going to kill up on the top lane. Kabu. He'll be protected right now. Structures are fortified. And that's from the Moonlight Shadow with the Morana. Banana's just hovering around this middle lane. He's got scouted out with a set of blasts into the tree line. He's still got Scorched Earth, but he doesn't have his ult, but he does have a Troll Trap. So he puts over on the Brewmaster, man, who doesn't have a split off right now. That Impetus damage, holy Hannah. Banana just goes down straight away. Finger of Death will be used to kill off the Morana, but then a Clap onto two. Sunshine's in trouble. There's enough damage for another Impetus. It won't be enough damage to kill off Sunshine. That's why he actually combined it up with the Urn Charge. Now Brewmaster looking to evade. He needs to Bottle Charge up as well. Doesn't really have the time into the tree line, but can't evade him there. Moon will be able to get a revenge kill finally on this Brewmaster. It's a nice 290 gold, making it now 7-9. But they're running out of the creep wave in middle lane, but they do bring Banana straight back towards that mid lane. I think they're trying to force into the tier 1 tower. With two of their cores here, you would believe they should be able to do this. As Howcop's a little bit of early damage, but he's coming down for what is now an Invis rune, so Banana gives the bottle charges over to Howl, and he'll actually take the Invis Rune. That do bring an LS level 6 as well. So with Invis Rune, he can move in nice and close and get the surprise out. And that just means a quick kill. Shackle over towards Moo. Hellfire Blast will also be committed. They're dropping him down half life, but Moo's already got himself a mech, so it's going to be okay. Kabu, well, he's got enough mana that he'll just reincarnate. It will be put on cooldown, which isn't really a bad thing. Got one last Hellfire Blast off. Nice Shackle. Zhao Wei and Banana are locked in together. And Kabu's back up alive again. But the Brewmaster caught right now with that Doom on him. So two heroes being for the price of one in favor of Newbie for the moment. But Banana, there's just too much damage. Fox is sitting on the sidelines here, just throwing out the damage. But it's Hal who's getting more and more with more of these Quill Sprays. Zhao Wei was also doing some decent work. That Dream Call as well as Orb damage was in perfect position. He's got Blink off cooldown in 1 second time. If Windranger tried to force the issue there, she would have gone down. Zhao Wei would have turned into that. But Hal and Brewmaster never even got his split off. That's that surprise effect of the Doombringer we're talking about. Kabu, what are you met, dude? You have no support whatsoever. They still have a lot of stuns available, not to mention silences, blink daggers, so they'll be in position for you. And with no reincarnation being available, you do not get saved by your second life. So an extra kill coming the way of Newbie. Free gold, free monies. And Newbie are looking a lot stronger than they did before. The fact this Doombringer could freely move around inside the jungle, because he's running bottle 2, there's no problem about his mana he had before. And Sunshine, they're even going to give him some space in the bottom lane. Maybe they can get him up to that level 11 and just amp up that Finger of Death. Well, double check as well for people on the live stream. Please let me know inside the chat. Is the live stream sounding good? Working good? We moved the studio up and I still ran a lot of tests yesterday to make sure it's going to be okay. But yeah, I just want to double check, you know? Want to double check. But 14 minutes in, 12 to 11, Newbie's advance just skyrocketed up. 7,000 gold, 7,000 experience. This is what it comes down to with like timing lineups. Tongfu, though, still need to keep the pressure on. If they can beat the aggressors in this game, then they're all good. That's the reason why they're smoked up right now. The problem is they can't, like, jump Kabu in. Oh, this is the way. Jump in by, instead the Brewmaster. Straight inside the split to get the stun over on Moo. But then the double stun comes in from line with the Doom over on the Morana. Kabu wears no ultimate again. They use a Finger of Death to make sure he does go down. A Shackle will buy a little bit of extra time right now here for Tongfu, but it may not be enough. The Dream calls down. It's already going to be taken out. Well, actually, yeah. 4 euros down for the price of zero. Fox trying to run away. He's got no Windrun available. And Hal, he's just trying to keep those Warpath charges up and running. Actually going to go into an SMY on this guy too. I can justify that one. Keeps the nails of goo flying out, but that's a perfect fight for Newbie. Absolutely perfect fight for Newbie. Again, Banana. You could say before that Doombringer's ulti was underestimated. In that fight, it actually did very, very little. But still, it did the job. It still did the job. They came through. They took all the damage they required. They tanked it up. The mage charge popped off from Viper. And then all the initial damage the Tongfu dealt was just destroyed. There was none of it left. And awesome to see in the chat that the live stream is good. Hello, Middle Ape. And goodbye, Fox. There's a Blink Dagger over on Sungshae. I love this from this guy. Now up to level 11 on the Lion. So the Finger of Death has this upgrade it's searching for. Banana. Troll Trap is potentially here, and he does actually go for it. It's going to allow How to come in close. Brewmaster's going to jump in. He doesn't have an ultimate available here. Banana just trying to TP out. Cannot get there in time. But Xiaowei, double rift, follow-up stun into the Enchantress. And they just keep the DPS flying out. Not to mention it's amped up with Xiaowei. Going to jaunt himself down for the last hit. Actually, he can't get it. How's the one taking it? But it's the DD room from Xiaowei. Now the mech charge from Viper. They jump in again. Leap away to safety, but Puck's attack does follow him up, and with the DD rune, there's more than enough DPS coming out. And Newbie, they've got control of this game back again. And Moostar's just attacking on the wilds. Hey, Jukin Funker 4. Flying creature beaten by bird with wings that can't fly. The story of the emu. I wonder if anyone actually in this stream actually knows what an emu is. Or even the old tales of the emu. The Dreamtime tales. How the emu became an emu. Good times. That's what this Wild Wing reminds me of. It just reminds me of emu. Oh, Kabu. I wish him all the best of luck up here. Because, like, you know something about that. You see how he's just posturing. That's all it really is. Like, he knows that at this point, with his level of farm, with an SMY as well as a Vanguard, he moves so quickly in and out and can tank up so much arrow. Ooh, Sunshank, he's dead. If early his coattails was a little bit bigger, the Mirana would have actually connected them. Wait, what are they doing? They're waiting for an opening. They can't see outside. The blink up by the Brewmaster gets away while Xiaowei, I think you really want to try and solo up the Enchantress. He does have himself a Dagon, however. It's only level 1, so it's not enough burst damage to bring down the Enchantress. It'd be wonderful if that was the case. Oh, middle lane. Doombringer's already down. Look at him drain it. This one talking about from Sunshake. He knows what he's got to do. Drain the mana out of the Wraith King and you get yourself a kill. Now, Mu, he's going to get the Meg Charge off, but he's already been brought down. Can they actually get themselves a collateral here? With the Dream Coil, Tongfu basically to overstay their welcome. Sunshed try to run after Fox while Viper is brought back into this game and they're chasing down Xiaowei, but Enchantress is really just caught out inside the river. Then an all back up from Xiaowei. With two heroes down from Tongfu, they can just force out the middle lane, especially with the buyback they already used from the Viper. They want to make this count. And that means a tier 2 tower in the middle lane. And Mu's doing the wise choice right now. He can't earn any money from getting Dyer's any last hits here. So he just lets Xiaowei take them all. And then attack directly towards the tower. But you're seeing Kabu's problem. That's why I love the Lion pickup, and I kind of wish this was picked up a long time ago. Because it's perfect up against the Wraith King. Blink in, stun, and now mana drain. And Kabu is bone dry. The Shackle won't be able to latch, and Kabu, he may have ult. He used one charges. That got him enough mana to come back alive again, which has really slowed down Mu. The Meg Charge will have to go again. Another double stun coming out from the Lion, and Howl's in the mix right now. Even if Mu dies right now, Howl will do all the work. Quill Spray's just beating through the life points here of the Brewmaster, even though he's balling up. I kind of just want to watch this one. I know people are dying on the West right now, and they just call the GG. There's no way they can repel firepower of this magnitude from Newbie. Mu is even able to survive through all of this, but it's GG. It's GG at the end of the day. So we say thank you very much to Tongfu. They had a really, really good start. There's a 3-0 at one point. They were shutting down the Doombringer inside the jungle absolutely perfectly, but the downside, they just weren't able to deal with that Bristleback when he came into play. The Brewmaster didn't do enough as far as chaos goes. The one time when, like that mid-fight that happened when he got doomed up with the Invis rune, that was kind of like the turning point for me, because that was when Newbie got control back completely. And then the Doombringer had space to go inside the jungle and just catch up with his farm, because even check out his goal per minute by the end of it. It's not great at 3-2-1, and he was running ahead of Myers. Actually, the Doombringer did absolutely nothing in this game apart from cast Doom. Most of the work was done by Bristleback as well as Xiaowei. But hey, they were the two heroes that were left a free farm in a way. So props to Newbie. They'll take the number one position over Tongfu. We'll be having ourselves a short break and coming back here for our second game and our last game of the night. It'll be Dreamtime going up against U5. So that'll be our final game for Group A, where we have Newbie going through in first position, Tongfu in second position, and the winner of this next game will take third position. It is merely a dead rubber, so it's more for a little bit of fun. So stay tuned, and we'll be back for more Chinese Dota.